हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक। सो इन दिस सेशन आई विल कवर POS मेथड, EVM मेथड एंड QMAP मेथड फॉर सॉल्विंग बूलियन एक्सप्रेशन। सो वेलकम टू वास्टेक चैनल। Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you. Hello student, welcome back. So now we'll see one more method of solving Boolean expression, that is POS method. POS method is nothing but a product of some method. Here we consider the sum term, the fundamental sum term, and we will finally try to find out the product of that fundamental sum terms from the truth table. So you can see here, in the diagram, you can see here from the diagram, we'll consider three input variable truth table. So the combination of three input or three input variable truth table is this one. Let y be the output here. So y be the output, that is 1101011. So for POS, we will consider those sum terms which is giving output is equal to 0 in the truth table. So here, this sum term, this is nothing but M2, we will consider. Normally, max term, sum terms are also called as max term. So Max terms are represented in this way. For example, 0, 1, 0, A plus B bar plus C. That is, this term, 0, 1, 0, A plus B bar plus C. Wherever 0, you represent that literal as it is. Wherever 1 is there, you represent that literal by bar. But in SOP, we used to represent this one. For example, in SOP, we used to represent this one with the A, B, A bar, B into C bar. But in POS, this becomes A plus this becomes complement. This product becomes sum. Then B becomes B bar, and C becomes, once again, product becomes sum, C bar becomes C, this one. So my dear students, you can see here various max terms. Max terms normally represented by M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, capital M we will use. So now, so how to represent three variable POS terms in KMAP. So this is a three variable POS term. A, I can take this one CD or BC also. Here in this example, you have taken CD. And this is a four variable. This is M0. This is capital M0. 1, 2, 3. So here A and C plus D, A plus C plus D bar, that is M1. A plus C bar plus D, M2, this is M3, M4, M5, M6, like SOP only, M7. But here we represent fundamental sum. Four, this is the four variable truth table. So like this, my dear students, we will proceed now to solve some of the problems in SOP. So this is one problem. Here you can see the problem statement is plot Boolean expression. The expression is given. You have to plot this one in KMAP. So by seeing this one, you will come to know this is SOP. So first draw three variable KMAP for SOP. Now, first term, A plus B bar plus C. Select A, then B bar plus C. B bar plus C will come here. Horizontal, sorry, vertical, and this is horizontal. Put here 0. Next, A plus B bar plus C bar. Select A, once again, B bar plus C bar here. Put here 0. Next, this term is equal to, becomes here 0. Next, here 0. So after that you can group it. So here just the question is just plot it. So plot it, don't try to solve it. So we'll see the next problem. Minimize the expression. So you represent this one. A first select A, then B plus C bar, where B plus C bar comes here, this is 0. Like this, second term, third term, then group zeros. SOP means you have to group zeros. So three groups, then try to solve it. Here you can see when you group like this, one group, one more group, and one more group. How to reduce this one? Here, just like in SOP also, here this will get negated, and B plus C horizontally B plus C will you will get. Here for this group. Vertically A, horizontally you can see B and B bar will get cancelled. So C bar remains. So that is C bar plus A, like that other group. So after this, you have to write POS, product of sum. See, this is sum terms. And product of this one, here in between you can see it is multiplication. Product of this one is called as... entire expression is called as a POS. Clear? Yes. So now next, my dear students, this one. This is also similar. Here also you can see, you have to represent, then after this grouping of one group, one more group, four zeros, and one more group. Grouping is similar to our SOP. So write particular, so minimize this one by writing down the answer for the particular group, then POS expression. Now my dear students, reduce the following. Now here, fundamental terms are given in terms of like this expression, in terms of this one. Here you can see function of four variable. And sum phi m, if it is given, it is understood that the problem is related to POS. So 0, 3, 4, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14. So represent this one, 0, 3, 4, 7, 8, 10. Then after that, make group of zeros. Some students will do mistake. Represent this one, they will make group of 1. Or what they will do is whatever elements given here, for that they will put 1 and rest of the place they will put 0 and they will make the group of zeros. No, that is wrong. You see, this one is here directly POS. So represent this one and make that group of zeros. So what is the answer for this one? This is the answer for this one here, because only two groups are possible. One is like this, one is like this, and one is this one. So here he has given don't care condition also. Mention that also, don't care condition. So two groups are possible. The answer for two groups is, this is the answer for two groups. And if you want to implement this one by using basic gates, you can implement, this is the basic gates, implementation by basic gates. So now, so next one is, in the next session you will see entered variable map. Hello students, the next method is entered variable map. So in the entered variable map, so what is entered variable map? First of all, entered variable map is the one method which we use to reduce the to solve the Boolean expression. What is the advantage of this one? First, we'll see what is this one. In entered variable map, what we are doing is, we are placing one of the input in the map itself. So one of the input is entered in the map itself. That's why it is called as entered variable map. That's why it is called as entered variable map, or map variable, map entered variable, MEV, MEV, or EVM, entered variable map, or map, and or we'll call this one MEV, map entered variable. So we'll see now this one with the help of one problem. So you can see here, given Boolean function, determine the SOP and POS using MEV technique. So determine the MEV, by using MEV technique, determine this one. So now here you can see the function is 4 variable. So 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. So draw the truth table of 4 variable like this. Then isolate the one variable LSB. Write the output. For example, 3 is 1. M0 is 0, M1 is 0, M2 is 0. Then now, you can see here, now we have 7 groups. One group is 0, second group is 1, third group is 10, fourth group is 11. So now, this first group, we'll call the first group is M0, or we'll call by other this one, D0, if you are getting confused with this one, D0. Now you see, when the input is 0, output is also 0. When the input is 1, output is 0. That means there is no effect of change in the input on the output. Output remains constant. When you change the input from 0 to 1, output remains constant. So we will take EVM as 0. Here you see, when the input is 0, output is 0. When the input is 1, output is 1. That means output is directly following input. That's why it is, I can say, D. Here you see, input is 0, output is 1. Input is 1, output is 1. When change in the input, there is no change in the output. Output remains constant, so 1. So here it is D. Here it is, input is 0, output is 1. When the input is 1, output is 0. That I can say, output like EVM is D bar. Like this, you represent this one. Then you have to map this one by using K-map. See, this is the K-map representation. So, whatever the terms you are getting here, that is this one, 0D, this one you have to represent. M0 means 0, M1 means D, M2 means 1, M3 means D, M4 means D bar. That you have to represent in K-map. Then, group it. So, here you can see, we made a group of this one, that is one group. This is the one group. Second one, this is the one group, SOP. third one, this one is combined with this one. So first one is the group of D only. So here, what is the answer for the first group? A get cancelled, and here you will get, I think you will get here. Here you will get C, but one variable is inside the this one map. So for this group, answer is C, but you have to multiply by D because variable is there inside the map CD. Now second group is this group. This is a group of ones. So answer is simple, B and C bar. No need to multiply by D. Third one is, this one I am combining with this one. That is also possible. So if D is equal to 0, what is D bar? 1. Group of 1, right? So it is a group of 1. So now here, see AC bar is the answer. And you have to multiply this one by D bar. So total final SOP is this one. Similarly, we have to go for POS. So this is the grouping of POS. One is D. Second one is let me check 1 minute. Yeah, second one you have to take a group of zeros, right? So second one is D. Second one is zero. So I think we are getting only 0 here only. So you have to make the group of that one. This answer is may not be correct. Let me check once again in the next class. So now we'll move to the next problem. Next problem is solved by using EVM method. Very simple. Once again, represent this one for this expression by using 4 variable. How we will come to know 4 variable? By seeing this one, see here, 15. That means it is a 4 variable. 4 variable can represent maximum 16, right? Here it is given 15. So 0 to 15. So represent 0 to 15. Represent Y. Isolate one variable. And you see here 8, 9, 10, 11 is a don't care condition. So you mention 8, 9, 10, 11 don't care condition. Then you see here 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is 0, this is 1, this is 1, this is 0. Then here 0, x, 1, x, let it be x. Then 0, x, 1, x, x, 0, 0, 1, 1. So like this, you represent this one and finally you make the group here. One group is possible, this one, this group is possible, that is DD and XX. So I can take the value of X as for SOP 1 only. So one more group is this one and one more group is this one. Three groups. So answer is this one. So now, once again, you can see here. This expression, you see here, this expression, WXYZ. Please remember, if they give WXYZ, use that variable only, don't use any other variable. It is given here, 5M, don't care condition. So you have to solve it for SOP, POS and EVM. So this expression is POS. From this, you write SOP expression. How to write SOP expression? Just complement of this one, right? So here, you see, 0 is here, 1 is here, 2 is here, 3 is here, 4 is here. So 5, 6, 7, T, 8, 9 is here, 10 is here. So 11, 12, 13, 14 is here, 15 is here. But once again for SOP also, don't care condition remains same that you write. So this is SOP expression. This is a POS expression. Now you have to group it. Once again, I will not go in detail here, SOP and POS. And other than that, we can solve this one by using EVM method also. See, this is EVM method also. Solve this one by using EVM method also. So with this, my dear students, we have completed EVM method also. The next method is QMAP. So why we are using QMAP? Now, one thing is, if you see KMAP, the grouping is totally depends on user ability. So, depends on user ability, different types of groupings will occur or may form. Second one is, if you see, it is simple for, KMAP is simple for 2 variable, 3 variable, 4 variable. But if the number of variable increases, then it becomes complicated. So, in order to overcome these both disadvantages, we are using QMAP. So, this is one more method of solving a Boolean expression. So, this will cover in the next session. Thank you.